मॉर्निंग टू एवरी वन, दिस इज़ द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर मेजर क्रॉप्स एंड केस स्टडी. लेट्स रिव्यू द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ क्रॉप्स विच वी हैव डन, दैट इज़ द फूड क्रॉप, कैश क्रॉप, बेवरेज क्रॉप एंड द फाइबर क्रॉप. टूडे फ्रॉम द व्यू पॉइंट ऑफ एग्जामिनेशन वी आर गोइंग टू सी द जोग्राफिकल कंडीशन रिक्वायर्ड फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर क्रॉप टू ग्रो. Fine. So let's start from the food crop first. This type of table you can see in your book it also. So for the food crops, firstly, please remember we have how many classification we have, how many parameters we have to see for a particular crop. We have three. So only three you need to write, like temperature, rainfall, and soil. That's it. So for rice, first of all, we are seeing the food crop. Rice. So for rice, you can see that a minimum temperature of 20 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius is required to grow. Rainfall is required over 100 centimeter, and clay loams and alluvial soil is required for it to grow. Whereas when we compare it to the wheat, see this type of differentiating or classifying can also come where you need to where you've been asked to compare the two different crops and their geographical conditions. So kindly make it sure that you learn and you can compare it well, that what type of food crop or what type of a particular crop can be grown in which type of temperature, rainfall or type of soil is required, right? So similarly, you can see of the wheat, 10 degrees Celsius at time of sowing and 50 degrees Celsius to 20 degrees Celsius at time of ripening is required. Rainfall, you can compare it from the rice. Rice required over 100 centimeter, whereas wheat required only 40 to 75 centimeter, not more than 100. And even the soil, we need well dried loamy soil for wheat to grow. Now you can compare them both with the maize as well. And then coming to the cash crop. So you can see that there is a variation of required temperature, variation of required rainfall and soil for a particular crop to grow. Now let's move towards the beverage crops. What were the beverage crops? Beverage means the crops which are required for drinking purpose. Again, the same classification is required, like temperature, rainfall and the soil. Fine. So this is how you are going to write in your exam. Okay, so the question which I need to share it with you all, that the question might come that where you need to classify, it might ask you that write on characteristic of a particular crop, means right, like I give you for write about any of the fiber crop. So there it will be your choice to select it from cotton or from the jute, right? But whereas I am asking you for a particular crop like cotton, write a characteristics of the cotton, you have to give me the three parameters: temperature, rainfall and the soil. So that is how you are going to write in your exam. Moving towards the major crop producing states and regions of India. If you remember, you can write these as your fourth point. By now you are doing the 3 points. Kaun kaun se 3 points aapko likhne hain basically? That is temperature. Then you have to write about rainfall. And then you have to write about the soil. And now the fourth point which you can include is the crop producing states. Fine. So you need to remember the states as well. So for states, you don't have to, don't worry beta, you don't have to learn all the names of the regions and states. You can learn about any of the two to three places, so that it is convenient for you also to remember. Like rice can be grown in the North Gangetic Plains, the Brahmaputra Valleys and the East Coastal Plains. Likewise, wheat can be grown. You can learn, likewise, if you remember, चलो अपने खुद के स्टेट का नाम याद करना इजी रहता है. यू कैन लर्न राजस्थान, पंजाब, हरियाणा, राइट. सो 2 to 3 नेम्स इज़ वेल सफिशियंट. और आपको तो मोस्टली डिफरेंट डिफरेंट क्रॉप्स के लिए सेम स्टेट्स में मिल जाएंगे. लाइक मेज़ में भी अगर आप देखो तो राजस्थान भी है, पंजाब भी है, राइट. सो इट इज़ ईजियर फॉर यू टू रिमेंबर देन. सो सिमिलरली यू नीड टू टेक आउट एनी ऑफ द 3 नेम्स फ्रॉम ऑल द क्रॉप्स एंड नीड टू रिमेंबर दैट. आई होप दिस मच इज़ क्लियर टू यू ऑल. सो रेस्ट वी विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. थैंक यू सो मच.